Well, conflict is right where it's at. Everybody knows the song by the Beatles. You say goodbye, I say hello.
Yes.
You say goodbye, I say hello.
Simpsons, if you love it, you'll let it go.
Well, here's the key thing though. We talked about conflict, and now here's the entire crux of a good place to start. Most people think conflict is the end of the relationship. We talk about irreconcilable differences. We here at Rockin' Relationships take the radical point of view, hey, conflict, that's the beginning.
That is truly the beginning of the relationship. How are we going to handle a conflict? Are we going to deny the conflict? Are we going to communicate and get through the conflict? Or is this conflict a message saying that we are not to have a relationship? Not that kind of relationship, at least. Because conflict is definitely a message. It's like a bulletin board. Yes, here we are. We are at an impasse. We're constipated, so to speak.
And check out the...
What are we going to do? Are we going to take some laxatives to smooth this on through?
But check it out. It's not even as simple as taking your own laxative yourself, because you need cooperation. Only the person that hurts you can heal you. Only the person that hurts you can heal you. Check this out. If it's your parent or somebody in the past, they're not the same person. You're not the same.
They don't even know they hurt you though.
You're not the same person. But wait, check it out. It's not about whether they know it or not. You feel hurt.
Here's the thing.
You need the same person to heal you, but it's not going to be your dad. It's not going to be your mom. It's not going to be anybody from the past. But you might run into somebody in your life, your lover, who all of a sudden, they remind you of those things in the past. And guess what? They have the ability to hurt you the same level as your parents back then or the people that were around you back then. And there all of a sudden lies the window of opportunity in trying to get that person to lean and stretch towards you. You get to heal. You get to have that ancient primitive brain think that parent, because that primitive brain has no concept of time or space.
Yes, but
if you get your lover and they hurt you in a similar way and they have some of the similar negative characteristics and they look at you and they're willing to change some of that for you out of love, fucking miracle.
I still say that most
fucking
of the time
miracle.
They don't know they're hurting you. You're the one who is perceiving they're hurting you. You're the one who's saying because they didn't do this or because they didn't do that, they hurt me. That's not fair. That's not fair because that parent didn't know at the time that they were doing wrong or that they made a mistake. I have told one
child,
yeah,
but in the NBA, Kobe can yell, I didn't mean it, but it's still a foul.
You do better than me.
But it's still a foul.
Okay, so what?
So you still gotta deal with it.
Learn from the foul ball, pick it up and get back on the mound.
There we go.
You know what I'm saying?
And where do you
pick
start?
All that as a parent, I'm not going to take it. You point out I did this wrong, Mom, you did that wrong. Okay, I did that wrong. Now that you've seen it, do a better job than me and leave me the hell alone.
And you start right there at conflict.
And what a wonderful thing to say, leave me the hell alone. To a grown child. That's a wonderful thing. Because that grown child has learned to say, so the hell what? And be strong and be confident.
Relationships and what relationships rock.
Keep it rocking.
Maddie Matt on the horn.
Thank you.
The harmonious voice among the three of us here.